Hi, my name is Victoria Ong and I'm the creator of Flowers and Threads. Today I'm going to be talking about the basic techniques for right and left hand users with a simple lace edging pattern. I want to thank all the people who subscribed to my channel and for getting me to 500 subscribers. Before we start, I want to go over a couple of tools. I highly recommend Elizabeth size 10 thread and gold tapestry needle number 18. You also need a sharp pair of scissors for your thread and an edging template or strip of fabric to work on. We are going to do a quick run through for right hand users first. You can create the lace edging on a guided template or the edge of your fabric or ribbon. There are two ends for the thread in Turkish needle lace, the tail end, which is pretty stationary, and the working end attached to our needle for tying the knots. We begin by holding the tail end over the left hand corner or left side of our work. Then we insert the needle into the hole or fabric corner. Notice how the tail end of my thread is over the tip of the needle. Grab the ends coming from the eye of the needle and wrap it around the tip two times in a counterclockwise direction. Pull the needle through the hole and use your hands to pull the slack from the thread to tie your first double knot. We will continue to tie knots in a series towards the right. Insert your needle into the next hole or space to the right of the previous knot. Bring the tail end of the thread over the tip of the needle. Then tie another double knot by wrapping the thread from the eye of the needle around the tip two times in a counterclockwise direction. You can also think of this as under and over the needle tip. Pull the tail end of the thread across and continue to carry it over as you tie two more knots to complete this row. Rows are built from bottom to top, so to get to the next row and the left side of our work, we will create a straight return loop. Insert the needle into the leftmost loop of the row below, then bring the thread from the head of the last knot over the tip of the needle. Grab the thread from the eye of the needle and wrap it around the tip two times in a counterclockwise direction. Pull the needle through to tie the knot. Now tie a knot in each loop of the row below. Make a straight return loop to get to the next row. Tie a double knot in the next loop of the row below. You can make small adjustments to your loop size by pulling on the knot head to take up some slack. Insert your needle into the only loop of the row below and tie a straight return loop. The last row is just a single knot at the top to give our lace pattern a nice sharp point. Now if you look carefully, you can see all the knot heads pointing to the upper right hand corner. The better you get with consistent loop sizes and spacing, the closer the knot heads align on a diagonal line across the rows. Flip to the back side of your work and weave the working thread to the bottom of your template or fabric. You can now flip to the front of your work and continue repeating this pattern along the edge. We will now talk about the basics for left-hand users. Hold the tail end of the thread over the right corner of your work. Insert your needle into the hole or fabric. Make sure you see the tail end over the tip of the needle. Grab the thread from the eye of the needle and wrap it around the tip 2 times in the clockwise direction. Pull the needle through and pull the slack from the thread with your fingers to tie the double knot. We will continue to work from right to left when tying knots in a series along a row. Insert your needle in the next hole to the left of your previous knot. Make sure the thread from the last knot head is over the tip of the needle. Bring the tail end of the thread over the tip of the needle. Wrap the thread coming from the eye of the needle 2 times around the tip in a clockwise direction. Pull the needle through to tie the knot, and then tie 2 more knots to complete this row. To get to the row above, we will create a straight return loop. Insert your needle in the rightmost loop of the row below. Bring the thread coming from the last knot head over the tip of the needle. Wrap the thread coming from the eye of the needle 2 times in the clockwise direction. You can also think of this as under and over the needle tip. Pull the needle through to tie the straight return loop. Tie a single knot into each of the loop from the row below. Tie a straight return loop to get to the next row. Tie another knot in the next loop of the row below. Insert your needle into the only loop of the row and tie a straight return loop to complete the pattern. flip the work to the back side and weave the thread along the edge to get to the bottom of the template edge or fabric. Flip the work to the front side and repeat the pattern along the edge. Now, if you look carefully, you can see all the knot heads pointing to the upper left-hand corner. The better you get with consistent loop sizes and spacing, the closer the knot heads align on a diagonal line across the row. That's the only major difference when you look at the two lace forms. The head of the knots are pointing in different corners. Thanks for watching this new video on basics for right and left hand users. Doing the left hand demo was a bit non-intuitive for me, but I really hope it helps others. This is a diagram that covers all the possible ways you could tie a double knot, so feel free to pause the video to look at the diagrams and patterns. If you love these videos and want to find more patterns, you can look for Flowers and Thread on Amazon for electronic copies and through my website for physical copies and printouts of my patterns. Last, I just wanted everyone to know that I'm teaching classes virtually through the Lace Museum in Sunnyvale, California, so please check out their website for online workshops and classes. They cover a variety of different lace making techniques as well, and they have a bunch of great instructors.